So recently I've been listening to a lot of alternative rap and R&B, and I would say that my favorite song is Houston Old Head by A$AP Rocky.
Okay, so Ricky, what kind of music do you listen to now?
Like heavy metal, really hardcore stuff. The stuff makes me want to cry. Mm.
So like in the last 4 years in high school, how has your music taste like changed?
Yeah, I started off as more of like a Swifty type of guy, and now I'm into, you know, like stuff that makes me not sleep at night.
Yeah. Mm. If you could play one song to show a teacher, what song would that be?
Ooh, that's a really good question. Something by The Offspring. Yeah, something by The Offspring. Probably go, I don't know, I kind of also sound like it makes someone cry. I feel like me and Mr. Hood bond all the time because he does some hard, hardcore stuff. So yeah, I feel like that'd be how I'd ask. Oh, okay, I forgot to say the name of my favorite Offspring song, but it's Gone Away. That's my favorite Offspring song.
No, I like some country here and there, but mainly rap. Yeah.
And what's your favorite song right now?
Don't Choke by DB by the Bag.
Okay, so like, what kind of music do you listen to now?
A lot of indie.
What kind of indie?
Anything.
Right. Are you an indie boy, would you call yourself?
Yeah, I would say I'm an indie boy.
So like, in the last like 4 years, how has your music taste like changed?
I used to listen to a lot of rap, and now I listen to indie. True Love Waits by Radiohead. Mmm.
Mmm?
Mmm.
What do you normally listen to?
Do I normally listen to? I'm kind of all over the place. I'm either, it's like some nice piano music, nice calm piano music, or like indie, or rock, or maybe even rap. No, I'm all over the place.
So like, what's your favorite song right now?
Favorite song right now? There's this one, it's called Kiwi by Quarters of Change.
What kind of music do you normally listen to?
I listen to a lot of classic rock.
Classic rock? And like, what's your favorite song right now?
I Can't Hold Back by Survivor.
Alright, you want to get this?
Huh?
You want to get this?
Sure.
So yeah, what do you listen to?
I kind of listen to everything except for country, but right now my favorite song is probably Rehab at Amy Winehouse.
Like, what kind of music do you normally listen to?
I'm more of a pop, indie pop kind of person. I'm listening to David right now. He spells it with a 4. I don't know if it's actually David, but I listen to him right now.
What's your favorite song?
Sleep Well. Yeah, right? That's a good one.
Alright. So like, what kind of music do you normally listen to?
I listen to a lot of classic rock.
Classic rock? And what's your favorite song right now?
I Can't Hold Back by Survivor.
She's behind the camera the entire time.
So what kind of music do you normally listen to?
Kind of music I normally listen to? I like reggae music, Hawaiian reggae music, Rebel Soldiers, Maoli, Kalohe Kai, all bangers.
What's your favorite song right now?
What's my favorite song? That's a good question. Hey, Prince Charming by Rebel Soldier is a great song.
Alright.
We're here with Mr. Anderson, and we're going to be reviewing music that the students from, the seniors from CB, they recommended, and it's going to be a blind reaction, so we'll see what he thinks of it.
As an audiophile, I'm very intrigued. Ready to be provoked by your selection.
Okay, so what type of normal like genres you usually listen to?
So good rule of thumb, if someone says that they listen to everything, they're not to be trusted with their musical taste or musical recommendations, because if you listen to everything, then like everything's good. You don't have any kind of like, you can't distinguish what's bad. That said, I'm on the kind of the indie side for the most part, but I do listen to a wide variety. It's kind of hard to pin down, but mostly indie. I guess okay. Would be.
Do you have a top song right now?
Right now? BBL Drizzy. BBL Drizzy.
Okay.
BBL Drizzy.
I can get down with that one. That's definitely one of my favorites right now, too.
Sweeping America.
Okay, I don't know.
Yeah, there's a bit of, like, I don't know, it's the problem in the background.
Yeah.
Behind us. I think you can't really see in the frame.
Okay.
So let's just I guess we'll just get going here. Just a few seconds from the song. And
okay, all right.
If you want to play some more.
Yeah, make sure we got the LR good here. Okay, let's do it.
Okay. We'll see what this first one is. Oh, not that one.
So what song is this?
This is Kiwi by Quarters of Change.
Interesting things about your guys' listening habits I've found like the last couple years is a lot of bands with kind of this androgynous falsetto like singer. Like initially like, wait, is this a guy or a girl? It's very high, like a lot of people are really into that. The song's alright. I enjoyed the bass.
Yeah.
Very, very funky bass.
Definitely a long song. It was like 5 minutes and 30 seconds.
So. Yeah. Some tasty riffs there at the beginning. It wasn't bad. That bass, I was really fond of it.
Next song we're going to review is Rich Baby Daddy by Drake. And I was like,
there. Right there.
It's just really easy to do. You don't have to use your hand.
And you're not pointing at it. You're just like, hey, look over there.
No. You're not supposed to point. Instead of pointing with your finger, you just use your mouth. Because you're not using your hands.
That's what I haven't really done. Every time I point at someone, like,
yeah,
I keep doing
it anyway. It's very obvious.
Yeah, and I also feel like, you know. Hey, over there. Yeah, look at him. Look at that. Give him that guy.
Look at that guy. One right there. You just go. Put him there.
We're putting them on.
Okay.
So,
have you listened to that song?
No, I've not.
Okay. Yeah, I'm curious to know what you're thinking.
Yeah, provocative. certainly. And you know, some people are like, oh my God, like he's listening to this crazy song about. But you know, I'm familiar with the work of City Girls, Glorilla, things of that nature. This isn't. Same time, like, song kind of died when Drake came in. I do think it's really weird to have a song about, like, have someone else singing about how they're dancing on you, and, like, it's your song. It'd be like if I came out with a song that the hook was, Mr. Anderson's the best, Mr. Anderson's the best.
Well, Drake's not taking many W's currently.
No, nor should he. And yeah, like it's. I think it's on brand for Drake. Song like
definitely
this.
So.
You know, talking about
funny enough, though, this is definitely probably the most popular song off the album. So
you know,
it did numbers.
People love songs about two individuals coming together as one on the dance floor. Mm. So beat wasn't bad.
Did you enjoy it at all, or?
I like the beat. The beat was okay. Good, but again, once Drake came in.
Okay.
Do one more?
We'll do one more, yeah.
Works.
Next song is True Love Waits by Radio.
So I'm a massive Radiohead fan.
Yeah, I figured you seem very knowledgeable about music, so.
So, I mean, this song, they had been playing this song live for like 15 years before they actually released it, and, you know, it's the last song on Moonshaped Pool, which is, seems like it's going to be their last record. I don't know if they're going to make any more music, and if this is the last song they ever publish, I think it's pretty fitting.
I agree.
A capstone to Radiohead. I mean, I don't use this word lightly, but everyone in the band is a genius. Musically especially, frankly, like, if you don't like Radiohead, or like you're like, oh, they're not that good, like, I really question your judgment and taste. It's one of those bands, there really is something for everybody, but you have to dive in to get it. So, a beautiful song.
I agree, yeah.
All right, do you want to recommend one song?
Oh, yeah.
Can I recommend three?
You recommend three songs, yeah.
Okay. It's hard to pick one.
Yeah.
So, some stuff I've been listening to lately that I think, you know, everybody might enjoy. One is this band called Howdy. They spell it H-O-V-V-D-Y. They had a new record that came out last month. There's a song on that called Bad News. That's really great. Feels like a warm hug. It's a good end of spring, beginning of summer record as well.
Okay.
Something else I'd check out, it's not on Spotify, it's only on YouTube. This band called Cindy Lee released this double album, this 2-hour double album. Again, can't stream it. It's long, but there are some absolute bangers in there. It's some really interesting stuff, especially if you're into kind of a little retro guitar work. Some really cool stuff there. And then, you know, for the hip hop heads out there, my guy, Mach Homie, just released a new single. I believe Catronato was on the production with that. So shout out to Haiti. Check out Mach Homie. Some good stuff there.
Okay.
All right.
Sounds good.
That's all. Thank you.
Thank you. Today we're here with Miss Anshu, and we're going to review some music picked by the students and see what she thinks. So I might just run some song titles by you and see which one you want to listen to.
All right.
We have Rehab. We have Sleep Well. I Can't Hold Back, Prince Charming. Just choose out of those, one of those four.
Let's go with Rehab.
Okay.
obviously.
Already know it. Love it. Is this the song that you guys listen to?
Well, this is, I'm familiar with it, and I know this is just one of the songs that one of the students recommended, so.
Excellent.
Yeah, I feel like we have a wide, range, and yeah, some new, some old, so.
Yeah, I think that song came out when I was in high school or maybe college.
Really? How old is that song?
It's old.
Oh, really?
20
I mean,
years?
The,
I don't know.
The biopic's coming out soon, too.
I know, yeah, I saw that. I don't know, maybe college? I don't know. It's been out for a while.
Huh.
All right, what do we got next?
Okay, so next we got Prince Charming by Rebel Soldiers.
All right. I don't think I know this one. We'll see.
Pretty good from what I heard, honestly.
Yeah, kind of funky.
Yeah?
Yeah, I like it.
Okay.
I'm not familiar with it.
Maybe we'll do next, I Can't Hold Back by Survivor.
All right.
Yeah, that does sound like some out of Top Gun. I know my dad is born in, well, not born in the 80s, but, you know, grew up on all that, so put that a little bit on me, too, but, yeah, definitely familiar with Survivor, but, yeah, again, with the different decades, got some now music.
I love the mix.
We have Gone Away by The Offspring.
All right. Definitely my era. Offspring was one of the first concerts my husband went to.
Really?
Yeah, so he would know it.
Okay, that's cool, yeah. No, I mean, I'm a little familiar with them, yeah. I think we do find a little appreciation for some of the other decades and eras of music, yeah. It's a different sound. So, next we have True Love Waits by Radiohead. I don't know if you're familiar.
I'm familiar.
Yeah.
Darling, darling, darling. yeah, Radiohead is I'm a big fan. I enjoy it. I don't know.
Oh yeah, when we talked with Mr. Anderson, he had a lot to say about that band. It seems like they have left their mark on.
Yeah, on like many generations, I think. One of my strongest memories of Radiohead is I went to like a summer camp when I was in high school, and this is actually not a good story, so just cut this. But anyway, there was a terrible, talent show at the end.
Yeah.
And someone tried to get up and sing a Radiohead song, and the mood went from like here to way down here real quick.
That's usually what their music does.
Yeah.
But
all for the right vibe, right?
It delivers a feeling, and I think that's what
into the heart.
That's what people look for.
Yep.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Okay.
More contemporary. I thought you were gonna make me
do what?
Gonna grill me or something. I don't
grill
know.
You?
I was
grill
nervous.
What?
I don't know. Like test me.
You wanna test her? You wanna get tested?
I don't really wanna be tested.
Okay.
Well, what do you think's the move now?
I don't know. What kind of music do you listen to, Sebastian?
Honestly, a little bit of everything.
A little bit of everything.
Yeah.
Do you have like certain favorite songs right now?
I love Dua Lipa
right now.
Dua Lipa?
Yeah.
Cool.
So a little bit of current people.
Yeah, that would be like a current person that I feel
like
I listen to a lot of. And I really like a lot of like bluegrass Americana also, so you know, a little bit of
That's cool.
What's one thing that you've noticed with like the evolution of music, like, you know, with nowadays?
I mean, I think what's just so interesting is if you were to do this interview 10 years ago, or I don't know, the time, it's wild to me that half the songs that we listen to are from, you know, the 80s, the 90s, the 2000s, and that you guys have a really, like, much broader depth of knowledge than I think teenagers historically have, just because you have the ability to kind of listen to it like that, right? Which is cool.
One thing I've noticed is like throughout all this is you ask around, everyone that you talk to just seems to have some difference in music taste, and it's not all going to be the same. It is very wide and broad, which is it's the cool part about it.
Yeah, I think also there's high school students like hip hop a lot more than when I was in high school. I graduated in the mid-2000s.
It's definitely taken over probably the top genre right now.
Yeah, I'm a big hip-hop guy myself.
Yeah. There is a song on this list. I don't know if you're too into it.
It's not my personal favorite, but I mean, I can appreciate
it. It's a pretty groovy song.
I'm more like 90s,
He's from Sacramento, right?
Who?
Oh, I wasn't going to talk about deep out of that.
What, bro? No.
Do you want me to play?
Maybe later.
It's got some words. We can play it for now, but I can turn it off as soon as you want me to.
Yeah.
So.
Should I do it, Mr.
Clum?
Yeah, do it. Why not?
Do it.
Okay.
I'm nervous now.
This is Don't Choke by BB.
Oh boy. You guys are covering your faces over there now. I'm nervous. Alright.
I won't torture you anymore. But to put in perspective, students here listen to that.
Absolutely,
type of
I mean, it's not what I would go to, but I don't mind it.
Okay.
Yeah,
so.
I would happily listen to that. But I wouldn't pick it up myself.
Yeah.
Fair enough,
yeah.
And I don't think, like, hip-hop and rap is all that. There's so many different forms and styles to it, which is kind of what makes it special and stuff.
Yeah, for sure. Which is, like, emerging in the current, you know, Drake and Kendrick Lamar. I mean, that's what it's all about, right?
Yeah.
That's ultimately what that argument is.
Listen to the songs, bro.
Which one?
What's your favorite? Have you listened to all the diss tracks?
Not all of them, but I mean, I've read about them more than I've listened to them.
Okay.
Which one?
Do you want to listen to one?
Oh my God.
Yeah, Not Like Us is pretty good.
Sure, yeah.
Or Euphoria, either one.
We'll do Not Like Us, because I feel like people have had that as a... I mean, the one baseball guy had is his walk-up song.
That's true.
Yeah.
Okay. Who was it?
It was Ian Happ.
Ian Happ?
Oh, yeah. Okay, this is Not Like Us by Kendrick Lamar.
All right, excellent.
I see dead people.
Put that on that beat. Hey, Mustard on the beat. Debo, any rap. He a free throw, man down. Call an ambulance. Tell him free, bro.
Okay, there. Yeah, yeah. Do you appreciate the wordplay there?
I do. Okay. Yeah, I think it's great. I appreciate Kendrick Lamar a lot.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Obviously taking shots at Drake and rumors and stuff. They're getting
all right. Well, that was not nearly as painful as I thought it would be. Yeah. Thank you, gentlemen.